going to shift gears a little bit then. Question is for whom? Okay, who is the saving call for? And whom is the Holy Spirit working by means of the preaching of the gospel? And of course, the answer to that is the elect alone. A few proof texts for that. Still, your Bible's open to Romans 10. You can just turn maybe back a page to Romans 8, verse 30.
Look at that first, Drew. I think we're up to you. Would you read that verse?
Moreover, whom he did predestinate, then he also called. And whom he called, then he also justified. And whom he justified, then he also glorified.
Okay, there you have predestination, election, and calling put together. So who does God call with this saving call? It's the elect, those who he has predestinated. Another passage that I don't have listed here, if you turn to Acts 13, verse 48. Acts 13, verse 48. Paul's preaching in the city of Antioch, and there are many who are coming to believe there in that city. And the question is, well, you know, why is this? And verse 48, I'm sorry, gives that answer. Nate, would you read that?
And when the Gentiles heard this, they were glad and glorified the word of the Lord, and as many as were ordained to eternal life believed.
Okay, this explains why some believe who hear the preaching of the gospel. It's because they were ordained to eternal life. So the implication is that election leads to not only redemption for their sins, but calling them out of darkness into light. So that would be another passage, and then John 10 would be another. We won't look at that one. We've looked at John 10 in the past and what it teaches about election and the work of Jesus Christ. All right. That means then that the elect who hear the preaching of the gospel have certain characteristics, certain spiritual characteristics. First of all, they thirst. Secondly, they're weary and heavy laden. Third, then, they are receptive to that call. This builds on certain passages of Scripture. Weary and heavy laden, that's what Jesus says in Matthew 11. He says to those who are weary and heavy laden, the command is, come, come to me. That's the call of the gospel. Come to Jesus Christ. That's what the gospel does. Those who thirst, that's Isaiah 55. There's a hunger and a thirst that God's people have for him. Now, understand this. Everybody in this world has a hunger and thirst. They want something. Hunger and thirst is just another way of saying they want something. They desire something. And what everybody desires is to be happy. What everybody desires is to find some kind of satisfaction, to find some kind of contentment. Everybody in the world has that. But what we have as God's people who are made alive is that we have a hunger and thirst for Christ and the gospel. The world, they have a hunger and thirst only for worldly things. But we have a hunger and thirst for Christ. And that's fed in us by the preaching of the gospel through the work of the Holy Spirit. That's why that's an amazing wonder. From my perspective as a pastor, it's really an amazing thing to see, and then when I go on family visitation, to hear people saying as well, we're fed by the preaching. That's not about me. I don't feed. I mean, I do. I bring the Word of God and so on. But the Holy Spirit's working in me, and the Holy Spirit's working in the church and in God's people. And it's all the more reason for us to praise God. It's good, and I'm thankful that people encourage me in my work and will say things after a sermon and so on. But in the end, it's not me. It's the Holy Spirit. And that's the question for each one of us. Is the Holy Spirit working in us? Our God, who gives this saving call, does this only for his people, and it's a gracious work of God. This is not for everybody. That's the point we want to see here. It's not for everybody. Yes, it's for those who are thirsty, who are weary and heavy laden, but they're that because God's made them to be that way, hungering and thirsting for Christ. So we see and understand tonight that this is all the work of God. It's the work of God only for his people. And so that's the question for us. Here's how we can know that we're the people of God. We not only hear preaching, a lot of people hear preaching. How do we respond to it? Are we repenting? And are we believing? Do we want it more and more? The salvation that God gives here is all of grace. That's part of this. If it's for the elect alone, it's all of grace. What's grace? Nate, you remember what grace is? Ashley will help you out.
Undeserved favor.
Undeserved favor. Don't deserve this. I don't. I deserve to remain in the darkness of my sin, but God calls me out, brings me out of that darkness and that sin so that I see and I know him. That's the amazing call of God. One last thing to look at tonight. Matthew 22. Verse 14. This is at the end of one of Jesus' parables where dinner was prepared. And you go into the highways and the byways to find people to attend this feast. And the end of the parable says this in verse 14, "For many are called, but few are chosen." So this verse gets at what we've just been talking about, the relationship between calling and election. It says there, many are called, but few are chosen. How do we understand that? What's Jesus teaching there? What's he saying there? Many are called, but fewer than that are chosen. Any idea what he's talking about there? Alex.
Many people like hear the preaching, but only some of them like believe it.
Okay. So if they just hear it, what part of the call do they have?
The external.
Just the external. Okay. It's important for us to understand that. There are a lot of people who have the external, but they don't have the internal. When you don't have the internal, you don't repent of your sins, you don't believe. That's what Jesus is talking about. There are many people who hear it, but they reject it. Why? Because they're not chosen, and they don't have the work of the Holy Spirit in them. That's the distinction he's making. So there's many people who hear the outward, but if they don't have the inward, and they're not chosen by God, they won't receive that call and believe that call either. Allison.
So some people who are actually chosen by God actually like do receive the external call?
Yes. They hear the preaching. Yeah. It's not just the elect who hear the preaching. There are a lot of people in Jesus' day, right, who heard the preaching and they rejected it. At home we're reading in the book of Acts and we're reading through the missionary journeys of Paul. What happens? They go into cities where it's the first place they usually go to. Synagogue, right? What happens when they would preach in the synagogue? Right? Yeah, many of the Jews would reject it. Okay? So they heard it. They heard, and they were called to repent of their sins and believe. They didn't want it. So Jesus talks about his parable in Matthew 13, the seed that falls in the different soils. Really, there's two. There's the good and the bad. And in the end, there, the three soils are the bad. It's the rejection of the gospel. There's the one good, prepared by the Holy Spirit. That's what makes that gospel grow and bear fruit. Okay? So, there are many who hear it, but we need that internal work of the Holy Spirit.